Have you ever found yourself overwhelmed by the options when trying to pick the perfect computer for your Proxmox setup? The possible choices are literally endless. So how do you choose the right one for you? Last time I promised to help you with that, so let's get into it. There are a few things that need to be taken into consideration. Before we jump into the hardware and all the technical stuff, we need to answer the first and most important question. What's your use case? I know some of you will be like, yeah, blah, 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 just tell me already what I should buy. But it's not that easy. I want you to really think about this question. Do you just want to play around and learn a thing or two about Proxmox, maybe upgrade later? Or are you a little bit more serious and want to build a fully functional virtual server in your home lab? Or do you need Proxmox to fulfill a specific mission in your small business? You can't lose any data or spend a week fixing broken stuff? Or are you building an enterprise-grade behemoth resilient to all kinds of disasters like users, multiple hardware failures, or power outages? Really, really think about it. Because if you don't, you will either waste your money, you don't have to, or God forbid, Proxmox will fail you at the worst possible time you can imagine. Okay, with that said, let's talk quickly about hardware requirements in general. There is, of course, something called minimum system requirements, but I think that it's not something worth even entertaining as an idea. You need a little wiggle room, even if you're only playing with the system. But for the sake of the information provided, let's have a look. CPU, 64-bit Intel or AMD, Intel VT or AMD V-capable CPU and mainboard. Almost all modern computers do support this. Minimum of 1 GB RAM, hard drive, 1 NIC or network interface controller. Imagine the most common network card with 1 gigabit per second speeds. The only important thing in this list is the architecture of the CPU. It needs to be x86/64-bit based. So any Intel or AMD CPU will do. Just forget about ARM processors like on Raspberry Pi or similar SBCs. Even though you can actually run Proxmox on Raspberry Pi, there's a whole project named PiMox built around this. Just don't go down that rabbit hole, it's a headache. So, on any Intel or AMD-based computer, you can install Proxmox, but I doubt you'll be able to do anything with the minimum system requirements stuff. So, discard this and let's talk real stuff. When selecting a computer for Proxmox, consider CPU power, memory, storage, and network capabilities. Don't take my advice as the only right answer to these things, but more of a rule of thumb when picking your device. The general idea is CPUs nowadays have enough horsepower to run all kinds of machines, but it should have at least 4 cores not to suffer while running 1 or 2 servers as VMs. Of course, the more, the better. Memory or RAM is your best friend in virtualization. Every VM should have its own memory space. Free memory can be, in a way, shared between virtual machines, but it often causes more problems than it solves. So I would advise against it. The more memory you can fit into your system, the better. Starting with at least 8 GB, but the more the merrier, especially for multiple VMs. Storage-wise, you want to have a relatively quick drive, SSD or NVMe, for your system, and maybe some HDD drives for storing data, VM images, and other stuff. For the higher tiers, you might want to consider having a NAS or network-attached storage as part of your virtualization solution. And when it comes to networking, you will be able to start with 1 NIC. But again, further down the road, you will probably want or need more than one. Let's say something like 3 to 4. One for interconnecting the cluster, one for communication with storage, and one for client connections. More on that later. So here comes the point where you should answer the question about your particular use case. I divided my hardware tips into 5 categories. First, playing around with Proxmox, exploring and learning. Second, entry level. Third, mid-range. Fourth, high-end. And fifth, budget-friendly, refurbished enterprise servers. So let's dive into these. First, the playing around level. On this level, you just want to install Proxmox on something that will be capable of running it with very few VMs and containers. As I've said, in my opinion, you will be fine with a 4-core CPU 8 GB of RAM, decent NVMe or SSD storage, and 1 NIC. Whatever you find that check those boxes will do you a good service. I've got experience with Zima board, Zima blade, and UE2X1. You can buy the UE2X1 with 8 GB of RAM and a 1 TB NVMe drive for around $180. Zima blade 7700 for $120 without RAM and hard drive, and Zima board 832 for $250, I think. Or you can buy refurbished older mini PCs like Dell Optiplex for about the same money. eBay might be a good companion here. The choice is yours, of course. The advantage of newer computers to refurbished older ones in this category is the lower power consumption of newer CPUs. If you want only to play around, you don't really want to raise your electricity bill to any notable degree. Moving on. Second, the entry level. To be honest, this is my favorite tier, I guess because I'm a home lover, or maybe because I already found so many use cases for computers in this tier. In fact, in this tier, I'll only recommend you one device, or better to say, one product line of devices. It's the Intel Nook Mini PCs series. They're simply great for all kinds of purposes in your home lab. I'll get to that in a moment. I just need to convey one important piece of information to you. The NUC product line was sadly discontinued by Intel, but don't be afraid, these devices are still being sold and the product line has been taken over by Asus. And besides that, other companies are producing very similar, if not identical, mini PCs. So you don't need to worry about losing the opportunity to buy computers like this one. So why Intel NUC? Well, simply put, because it delivers everything you need right from the beginning. And you can expand on it further down the road. I'll explain. The typical example would be something like this. You can run Proxmox on a decent device, and you want to have the capability to expand upon it in the future. Look, I have this Intel NUC 12th generation WSK i7 model. It's got an Intel Core i7 1260p CPU. This CPU has 4 performance cores and 8 power efficient cores, combined providing you with 16 threads. It's got the Intel Iris Xe graphics chip, and you can fit up to 64 GB of DDR4 RAM into it. You can also fit 2 M.2 drives into it, and it has 1 2.5 gig Ethernet port. Perfect, all the boxes are checked. You might argue that I myself said you will need more than 1 NIC down the road, and that's still true. Look, this computer also has, among other things, 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports and 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2 port. So, if you ever need to add more network cards to this device, you can just buy something like this, a Thunderbolt or USB-C to Ethernet adapter, and you're good to go. Or if you're crazy enough, you can even buy a Thunderbolt to 10 gig Ethernet adapter. So it really isn't an issue making this baby have 4 NICs. And the pricing? You can buy one of these, depending on the specs, from $200 to $600. So basically, it depends on how much you want to spend. To be honest, I love this device. Powerful enough CPU, 64 GB of RAM, possibly terabytes of storage, and multiple NICs. All this in a small form factor mini PC with a TDP of 45 watts. I've tested it by rendering a 3ds Max scene, and the power consumption is kept at 60 watts under full load. That's very reasonable considering how much punch this computer brings to your home lab. So, if you ask me, go for this one. Okay, to the next level. Third, the mid-range tier. At this tier, we're well past the $1,000 per node or per computer mark. And that's somewhat of a baseline. The cost can go up significantly, depending on what kind of hardware setup you desire, even to $2,000 or $3,000. In this tier, we are mostly looking at tower servers like Dell PowerEdge T150, Lenovo ThinkSystem ST250, HP ProLiant ML110 or higher models. You can consider all three of these options as viable for running in business-grade setups. All of these servers harbor Intel Xeon or AMD EPYC CPUs, have somewhere between 32 and 128 GB of ECC RAM. The ECC RAM stands for Error Correction Code RAM. It's the type of memory that can detect and correct common kinds of internal data corruption in RAM, especially in critical environments. They are slightly slower than non-ECC RAMs and cost more, but are kind of a gold standard in server environments. This kind of server can fit multiple disk drives. The ballpark number will be something between 8 to 16 drives in this price range. And very often have already multiple NICs with different speeds ranging from 1 to 10, maybe even 25 gigabits per second. And maybe you'll get a redundant power supply unit as well, meaning you can power this server from two different sources in case one of them fails. For this kind of money, you can clearly see the trend here. Everything gravitates to more performance, enhanced safety and security of your data, and redundancy in connectivity, either to the network or power supply. Okay, I think this is where it all kind of ends for us hobbyists. The next tier is the high-end enterprise-grade systems that really only larger companies can afford and make use of. In short, the price tag here is somewhere between 10 and 50,000 of good old US dollars. Basically, more CPUs, more threads, higher frequencies, hundreds of gigabytes of RAM, hundreds of terabytes of storage, faster networking up to 100 gigabits per second, or even more, multiple NICs. You got the gist. Bigger, faster, stronger. Moving on to the last tier, which we can still make use of. And those are budget-friendly, refurbished enterprise servers. You know, the stuff that is already too old for companies to use. They need, of course, more up-to-date hardware. But it's still good enough for us to play with. And they're giving it away basically for free. Well, almost free, considering that you get your hands on enterprise-grade stuff for the price of an older PC. Heck, if you're in this field, you might even have luck asking companies in your area if they're getting rid of their old stuff by any chance. I've seen that happen many times. If I had to point you to a device from this tier, it would be something like Dell PowerEdge R430. You can buy this stuff refurbished with 64 gigabytes of RAM, with two CPUs and 28 cores, with four NICs, with semi-large storage space, two power supplies, even with a few years of warranty for something like 500 to 1,000 bucks tops. That's a great deal, in my opinion. But sure as hell, it has its own drawbacks. These rack-mounted enterprise servers tend to draw some power, are most likely very loud, and are rack-mounted. So you need to take all of these things into consideration. If you have a separate room with a rack in which you can fit these things, then you're probably fine. I just want you to keep these things in mind before you jump to eBay or Amazon. Conclusion? Refurbished servers such as this Dell PowerEdge R430 or HP alternatives provide excellent value. They offer enterprise-grade hardware at a fraction of the cost of a new equipment. So there you have it, guys. Choosing the right computer for your Proxmox setup doesn't have to be a pain in the A. But you need to consider beforehand your actual needs, plan for the future, and pick a system that fits your budget. In the end, it's all about the value you got for your money. If you found this video helpful, give us a like, drop a comment with your thoughts, and then always keep learning and keep helping. Thanks for watching. Now continue to our next episode where I'll show you how to install Proxmox step by step. Or check out this other video.